Hi YouTubers, Phoenix Talon back with you again for another Creativerse tutorial. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do today. We are going to build a couple of simple elevator shafts, one going down, one going up. And we're gonna do it in my new build, my pet capture area, if you will, or maybe pet collection area. Okay, so I tell you what, we're gonna just use a few items. It's going to be real simple. I don't want you to stress out, and this is going to be very, very, very easy. Okay, so if you've never made an elevator before, this is where you want to look. Okay, so stay tuned. Okay, so we're going to start with the elevator shaft on the downside, and that's going to be over here on the left. Okay, the right side will be reserved for up, so left will be down. So if you can see right now, we've got three different floors going on. All right, we're gonna start with the top floor and then work our way down. So let's go ahead and get on over. Okay, so I've got what trap door I wanna use. So we'll go ahead and remove that block of salt right there and go ahead and throw in our trap door. Press R and hold so that we can rotate. Where'd it go? There it goes. Oh, I gotta love the graphical glitches in R36, don't you? Okay. Now, I want to do this elevator a little different from the one that was over there in our machine area, in the machine tutorial area. I want to go ahead and have some LED indicators that tell me if it's ready that I can use it to go up or down, meaning I want a green light that tells me that it's going to, or that it's ready to go down, and a red light that tells me that somebody's in it, so don't get in it. Okay, so we're going to go over here, we're going to take that one out and put an LED there, take that one out and put an LED there. Now, the middle part is where our butto is going to go, our pressure plate, our button. So we're going to take this out, and we're going to go ahead and, I don't know why I took those out, I meant to take those out, there you go. And we want to go ahead and put salt all the way around back in there, because you can see around the button, okay? See, if you look, if it was just dirt, it would look really weird. You got to remember to keep your builds looking smooth and clean. All right, well, you don't have to, but I do it because it's me, you know? Okay, so that's going to be our functionality. So we got this right here, we got that right there, that works. And just to test to make sure we don't die, let's go ahead and stand in here. We'll open this up. Boom, there you go. No damage. It works. So that's a good fall for us, okay? So let's get back up there without dying. That would be nice. No. Okay. Not happening. Okay, let's do this again. I fail at flying. No! Yep, there it goes. You know what? Let me just get back up here. Alright. Hey, what's a tutorial without a little comedy? Alright, let's potion that up. There we go. And I want all of my machines to be hidden back here. Now, there's something interesting that we got to keep in mind with this. It's going to be real easy. It's still just going to need our logic gate and our clock or our delay gate for the functionality of this. So let's go ahead and get that set up first. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and take these down. I happen to know that it's just dirt back here, so this is gonna be too easy. We'll just set up right here. Okay, so initially we just need our logic gate here, and let's get out our wiring tool. We want this to be set to AND, which it already is by default. We go ahead and get our delay gate, we'll put that here. We want that to be set to 0.5 delay. Give or take. We can adjust it later if we, you know, find out that's too quick. But currently there's a little bit of a delay thanks to R36 and all pressure plates. So because of that, it actually allows for this to work pretty well. So that's all right. So we're going to go ahead and take this right here. We're going to take our output from our pressure plate, send it to both inputs of our logic gate. So we're going to grab both, take that and go to both. So there you go. Now we're gonna take this logic gate output and we're gonna throw that right in here to our delay gate. Okay, perfect. Okay, so now we gotta take the delay gate and put it down to our trap door. So we'll take the output from our delay gate and throw it into our trap door. This will work. As a matter of fact, we can go ahead and step in here. Choo-choo, and there you go. That's down. That is all the functionality you need to go down. That's it. Okay, I remember telling you that the functionality for down was quite easy. Okay, I'll just ignore all these little lights and things here. Here, you know what, I can get rid of those. Well, but then you can't see the wiring over here. Okay, so that's all the functionality you need to go down. We put that on every level, and we're actually going to be okay. So we might as well do that just so that we can say that we've got a functional down elevator. So let's go ahead and do that real quick, and then we'll worry about the LEDs here in a little bit. So let's go way down here. Okay. I still want the same functionality to be down here as what we had on the first floor. So we still want to go ahead and put a trapdoor here. So let's go here. We know we want an LED there, LED there. Pressure plate is going to go right in here with salt on the sides. So let's go ahead and put that salt in there. LED there, LED there, and pressure plate there. Rotate. Perfect. Okay, so there we go. Now, the machine is not going to go here. If you remember, it was... Or is it there? Yeah, I think it does go there. Let's go up and check and make sure. Totally forgot now. It's my room and I don't even remember. Okay, yeah, it is there actually. Okay, but it's not going to go because I think it sticks out one. So it's not going to go there. It's going to go in one. So it'll still be exposed when we do this. Okay, so it's still going to be exposed. And we'll have to put in a wall over it. Okay, so we'll do that. And we'll go ahead and take our AND gate, our delay gate. Let's go ahead and get rid of this. We'll put that somewhere else, like, oh, I don't know. How about up there? I'm not using that spot. All right, let's get our wiring tool out. We're going to go here, grab this to go to both sides or both inputs of our AND gate. Output of AND gate goes to input of delay gate. Output of delay gate goes to trapdoor. All right, let's go ahead and check this to make sure it works. There it goes. And that's it. That's our functionality. Too easy, right? Because there's going to be another floor down here eventually, so that's why that needs to go down. I don't know exactly how many floors I'm going to do, but yeah, it'll be cool when I do. Okay, so there you go. So that's functionality on that floor. Now we need to take care of the middle floor. This is how easy this is. I hope you're all having a good time following this, because this is really, really just too easy for us. All right, let's go ahead this way, get out our door. We'll go ahead and rotate. LED there, LED there, button goes there. All right, let's put our salt. Clink, clink, clink. LED, light, camera action. Rotate the button. There we go. Remove the wall. There we go. Remove the wall. Not there. There we go. Logic gate. Delay gate. Now let's go ahead and wiring tool that. All right. Output of button goes to input of AND gate. Both inputs. There you go. Output of logic gate to delay gate. Output of delay gate to trapdoor. I don't remember if we set the other one. We'll have to go down there and check. Okay, check this one, 2.5, there. Okay, and let's go down there and check. Whee. Let's get off of it. Yeah, I don't think, that was pretty fast. That was no delay. All right, yep, there was no delay on that one. Okay, and there we go. We want it to be fast enough that it'll let us go down without much delay, but slow enough that even my slow self could get over there. Yeah, there we go. Awesome. All right. So let's go ahead and check the functionality of this. So we jump on this. We go down. But I didn't want to go down that one, so I get off. Plenty of time. You see how it still worked for us, though. Get on this. Okay, I want to go all the way down. There we go. All right. Perfect. Excellent. Functionality works. Now we need to start thinking about our lights. So we want this to have the green light showing us that everything's okay. And we want to have a red light showing us that somebody's using it. So we need to have a universal gate that this can go to, or three different gates from the clock. Because here's the thing, if I take this output from the clock and go to each one of the lights, and then one from there to all the lights, and then one from there to all the lights, they're going to have the same outputs that are going to these trap doors, and all trap doors are going to open at the same time. If you're not understanding what I'm talking about, it's talking about the naming convention of your output. All right, and it will. It will take the same name because it has to, because that's how this game works. So what you need to do is you need to have something that it doesn't matter where the output is going or coming from. So these delay gates cannot have a shared output. But if you send it through another logic gate, then they can, you see? And then you can also have this logic gate go through a single, or all of the logic gates go through a single inverter, and that inverter can go to all the LEDs. You see? Aha! So we need to add another logic gate to these so that we can get this to work for us. And we only want it while the clock is running. Okay? So that's what we're going to do. So we're going to take that and put it here to both outputs, and we're going to make that another AND gate. And it should already be, so it is. Good. Now, we need to go ahead and do that to all of them, but let's decide how we want this. So when it's true, down here, we want it to activate the red light. And we want the top one to be our red light. So let's get in here and turn this to red. Because, and can interact, we want to false, because we only want the elevator to turn that to false. So we come over here and throw that to that one. Now, what about this green light? Well, we need an inverter for that. And I think we're going to go ahead and take the inverter and put it all the way up at the top floor. I don't know why I like that idea. I just do. Okay. I think it just, it's a nice place. And I think we'll just throw it right there on that side. At least then I'll know where it is. And I don't have to guess if it's on the third floor or fourth floor or 10th floor or whichever floor. Okay, so we'll go ahead and we'll wire that one here in a minute. But we can go ahead and change that to a green light and change the can interact to false. So let's do that while we're here. Now, let's check the functionality real quick. There it goes. And there it goes. Okay, so perfect. That's what we want it to do. So let's go ahead and get up here to the first floor with us. There we go. Awesome. Can't believe I actually did that. Okay, so we want this to go right, why can't I, there we go, right there. And we want to throw this inverter, we'll throw it right in there. Perfect, awesome. Okay, so we still need a logic gate down here though, so let's go ahead and do that. Now we're going to take, again, like I said, from just like we did below, take the output from the clock and put it to both sides of this AND gate. Take the output from the AND gate and put it to the red, which this is going to be a red light very soon. There it goes. Now it's a red light. Can interact to false. Hit save. Now we need to take this and send it to the receive of the inverter. Okay? The inverter is then going to go to all of the green lights. So this one's not green yet. It will be very shortly. And can interact to false. There we go. So now, in order to get that to be green, we're going to have to hit that to reset. And should be sending out a true. There it goes. Okay, I just wasn't on it long enough. I was like, okay. All right, sometimes, like I said, you have to, you know, jog the memory of it, or memory, the light to make sure it works. And in that case, we got it to work. Okay, so let's go ahead, and we need to copy-paste this, this send right here. So let's go ahead and Control-C, the send of that. So we'll hit save. Well, we didn't have to hit save. You could hit cancel. Alright, so now we remember this setup, right? We need one more logic gate down below. Alright, so let's get off of there so it doesn't come back for us. Alright, we need an AND gate right here. We're going to take our output of our delay gate, put it to the input of both of the inputs of our AND gate. Take the output of the AND gate. We're going to put it into the red light, just like we did before. It's not a red light yet. It will be very shortly. Red light. Can't interact to false. Now, this is our green light. So we're going to go ahead and enter our green light. This needs the output from up there. So we're going to go ahead and control V right here. Green light. There we go. Awesome. Okay, so we're good so far. All right. Now, I just realized something, and we're gonna take care of it. Some of you may have realized it already. All right, let's go ahead and get this green light to work. Green light. Okay, there you go. You know why it's not working, right? Because this is not going up to the inverter. So we need it to go to the inverter. So let's go ahead and do that. So we need the send of this to go up there to the output. But the easiest way to do that, because we need the output here. Oh, there we go. Okay. And you'll understand what I'm about to do here in a minute. Because remember, we need them to share. We need them to all share the same naming convention. So let's grab that naming convention. All right. This is going to be the easiest way to go about doing this. Okay. Oh, I could have just gone down. But you'll see what I'm talking about down here. All right. In order for this to work, we need this to all share the same naming convention. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's put the output here. All right, notice it just went all the way up there. Let's change this to the same one for the inverter. There it goes. Okay, so now all that should be working. Awesome. Now we need for the green light to come from the inverter. So let's go do that. And there we go. I was going to say, I shouldn't have lost the red. Okay, good. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, hey, you know what? That's just as good because we need to be up here anyway. Because we got to change the outputs for these. Okay, so let's change that one to the one that was up there. There it goes. Let's change this one to the same thing. Nice. Awesome. So now, there it goes. That's what we want. Okay. So now, I think we've still got one more that's not working up there. I could be wrong, though. Could be wrong. The green light coming from here. So we need the green light. Copy that. Save. Well, cancel save. And we need to go all the way down to the bottom. There we go. That's so cool. I'm going to incorporate that into all my builds. I'm going to put like a pool of water somewhere. Just anywhere. Alright. Now, this green light needs that one from up there. And let's jog its little thing here. There it goes. Nice. Okay. Everything should be working. All right, let's go all the way to the top. All the way to the top. And we'll try it out now. All right, this should work. Okay, so we're here. Now, let's watch this. Red light. There it goes. Green light. Red light, because we were just on it, trying to reset it. There, green light. Red light. There it goes. That's awesome! It's working perfectly, exactly as we want it to. So that's it right there. So we've got our drop elevator working beautifully. Now, if we want more of a delay, we can go ahead and throw that in. I don't know if that's what you guys want to have. If you want like a whole second delay, you can do that. So let's see what that looks like. 1 second. And we'll go down here. There, that's a whole second delay. We'll put a second delay on this one. There we go. So we'll put a whole second here. There we go. That's a whole second. And we'll do the same thing with this one. There we go. And then one. There it goes. I tried to time it just perfectly, and I did. That's awesome. Okay, so we've got down. Down is taken care of. Excellent. All right, let's go cover up our wall because we're all about working clean. Oh, there we go. All right. I hate that it keeps turning you back the way you take off. Okay. So we like to work clean. So let's go ahead and put this back down. And there we go. Awesome. We have a couple more to place down. Did you see how it turned red as I was going down? It's letting you know you can't go there. That'll become really important when you have like a tall building, you know, with lots of ways down. That way somebody who's, you know, like on, you know, the fifth floor doesn't try to go down when somebody's up on the third floor trying to come down, because you could create a situation in which somebody's falling too far and falls to their death, or, you know, where it just ruins the functionality of the elevator. And then if I remember correctly, we didn't have anything to put down here. And it just goes green when it's all done. That's so awesome. Okay, so there we go. So that's how we're going to do that. Now we're going to do the other side exactly like that. So stay tuned for up. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and get started on up. Now I think it'll be best if we start up from the lowest floor. So that way we kind of get an idea of what we're doing. Now this floor is obviously going to have more floors below it. So we're going to go ahead and get this removed and get this set up as if there was going to be a floor below it as well. But all we're going to do is add the trap door for it. Okay. We're not going to add any of the functionality for up coming from the bottom floor, because each floor is going to have its own machine set off to the right of it. Okay. Now, let's go ahead and start setting this up the same way as the other floor. We know we've got to have an LED for that. We got to have salt to go ahead and fill in the ugly spots. So let's go ahead and do that. LED, LED, ugly spots filled in. Pressure plate is still going to be a thing. So let's get that down here. So the two are going to look identical. Now, the difference is going to be that up here, we're going to need some kind of trap door. But it's got to be right here outside of the LED. So you're going to have to, in order to do this, see, because if you hit right click on that, it just turns off. So you're going to have to hold shift and hit right click in order to get that to place properly. Now, if you can see it, you're going to, or if you can't see it, you're going to need a block, or, you know, to stand on. Or if you know that they just kind of rotate this way. And then you can test it by, you know, clicking on it and see, make sure that you got it opening and closing the right way. So that's one thing that we're going to need. The other thing that's different, that's not the same as over here, is we're going to need fans. So again, if you right click this, it's just going to go ahead and open. So you're going to shift and right click on top of it so that it goes ahead and is facing up. Otherwise, it'll face out and it's going to blow you off of whatever you're working on. All right, just right click. See, like that. See, I told you. All right. So while you're on it, you can't, it's hard to right click on these. So click on something else. Like here, let's get rid of that in our inventory. And you'll see, you got to find a spot that's clickable. Sometimes these little things work, sometimes not. It just depends. Hitboxes are weird, you know? I don't know what to tell you. All right. We also need a fan up there. So if what you may want to do is go ahead and go to the fan, copy the rotation by hitting R and highlighting whatever it is you want. And then on the square above the trapdoor, that's where you're going to go ahead and place that fan. And then you're going to go ahead and turn it on. Oh, see, it worked that time perfectly for me. Okay, so let's go ahead and set that up on all the other floors, and then we'll get to actual functionality. Okay, so let's do that real quick. Let's fly like an eagle. Yay! There you go. Alright, so I accidentally went to this one. That's fine. We'll go ahead and get this set up. This will be different from the one below it. Well, you know what? We'll do that one next. I don't want to confuse you. I want you to already understand what we're doing here. Okay, so let's get that. We'll go ahead and put our trapdoor down. Again, R for the rotation. And I rotated that wrong. There you go. All right. We know we're going to have LED, LED, and we're going to have get rid of these ugly blocks. So block, block, block. There's the light. There's the light. Let's go ahead and put in our pressure plate. Bam. There you go. And now we need another fan and another trap door up there. So let's go ahead and shift and right click, remember. And there we go. So that should work. All right, go ahead and shift and right click down. All right, let's turn that off. Nope. There it goes. Sometimes it works. I guess that one will be a good one that you can click on. So there you go. All right, go ahead and grab that for rotate. Highlight the block above it. If you can't, you can jump up. Bam, there it goes. All right, and too easy. Okay, so we go ahead and do that on the next floor up. And fly down. Oh, ouch. Why can't I? Here, let's get out of that button. There we go. Yep, this is going to be all about this is going to be a tutorial about falling. I should have it. I'm glad I don't make tutorials about flying. All right, so this one's going to be different. All right, we still need a door here. So let's get that down because we know we need that. Oh, good. There we go. Okay, and what else do we need? Well, that's really it for the most part. I mean, because it's going to push us up here, and then this is going to close once we get it. So let's go ahead and do this. We get that. We get that. We get these taken care of. Boom, boom, boom. And Abuto, thank you for the button. There we go. Okay. So that's pretty much it, because what it's going to do is it's going to push us up here, and we're going to hit that, and then it's going to close this once we get up here. Okay? So that's not going to be an issue. If it turns out to be an issue where you have to activate this fan as well, then you can go ahead and do that if you need to put a fan here if your fans are too low. But what I found is that the fan where it is right now is usually enough to hold you up just long enough for you to get that to go up. Or to get this door to swing up to go ahead and stop your momentum. Okay, so we've gone ahead and gotten that taken care of. So we know that the machine is going to go on this wall, but let's go downstairs and get this started because the up portion is going to need a different setup than these. Well, not much of a different setup, but you'll see what I mean. Okay, so here we go right here. So this right here is going to be, actually we didn't need anything on that upper floor, but we'll do it for consistency. Okay, we'll probably get rid of the button and the other stuff just in case, but that's more to set up if you're going to go keep going up, I guess. So we'll look at that and we'll see what we want to keep and what we want to throw out. So let's get these out of here. Again, we're going to have to move this torch somewhere. I'm not using the spot over here. So is that where I ended up putting the other one? I don't know. I guess it was there. I like to be consistent. Okay, so when this goes up, it's going to do the same thing as what this one is doing to come down. So we're going to go ahead and need a logic gate. We're going to need a delay gate. And we will need another logic gate at some point for the lighting, okay, because we already know that. And we'll throw the inverter up there if we want to go ahead and just keep things all nice and consistent. Okay, so let's get our wiring tool out. We're going to take the output of this, throw it to the inputs right here. And we're going to take the output, throw it to our delay gate. We're going to take our delay gate, and we like a second, I think, right? 1 second is good. So we're going to go ahead and do that. And now we've got to figure out what is going to be turned on when we are going up. Well, we need both of those fans to go on, and we need both of the fans and this trapdoor and that trapdoor to go into their open state. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. So we'll go ahead and send that to this fan right here. We'll go ahead and send that to that fan right there. Send that to the trapdoor. Why is it not? Can't seem to hit the trap door from here. Or is that the trap door that I already got? I think maybe that's already the trap door. And let's see if we can get the fan then. Why am I not able to hit that? Okay, let's try it. No, that's already there. Okay. Is it because the fan is too close? Let's try that without the fan being there. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and restart and see if that's just a glitch in the game. Okay, well, I'm not quite sure what's going on with that glitch there. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna work around it, and we're gonna grab the output here. We're gonna control C the output. Go ahead and come up here to the trap door. Go ahead and grab in here and go ahead and press our output there, and it still works. So I don't know what the glitch is all about there, but we can do better, faster, stronger, and without less grief. So let's go ahead and do that. And that grabs that one. And if we're lucky, let's do that. There we go. And we'll go ahead and hit save. Now, the other thing that we want to do that we've been forgetting to do, and it's my fault because I haven't told you, is we want to go ahead and set all the trapdoors to can interact as false. Mostly that's just to save a person the grief of being able to open the door and falling to their death. So we'll get the other one up there when we get a chance. And this one down here, I think I can only reach it from here right now. So we'll go ahead and go down here, can interact to false, and we'll go ahead and save. Okay, so we'll take care of that. So yeah, don't know what that was all about. Just a really interesting little glitch there, and it is what it is. The other thing we want to go ahead and do is the fans. We want to set those to can interact as false. That's what actually made me think of it for the trap doors, is because we don't want those to be interactable. And then the other thing that we want is that one, can interact to false. There we go. Okay, so that should go ahead and send us up for 1 second, and then it's going to go ahead and cut that off. So let's see if it works. That's it. That's it. That's how easy that is. So if you don't like the 1 second delay, we can set it to a half second delay. I don't know what you like. So let's go ahead and set that to a half second. See if that's something that you like. And you can leave even before it, you know, finishes its cycle. Okay, so there you go. All right, let's go ahead and this is why I said we'll set up the downstairs one before we set up the upstairs one, because they get easier as we go up. See? All right, so now we've got all the downstairs stuff taken care of. Let's go ahead and remove this wall so we can get this taken care of. All right, remember, we're going for functionality first, then we'll do the lighting. All right, so let's get the AND gate, the delay gate, and we know we're going to need another AND gate at some point. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and grab our outputs from our pressure plate. Go ahead and throw the output into both of the inputs of the AND gate. We'll go ahead and throw this into our output from AND gate into the input of the delay gate. We'll go ahead and set our delay. We like a half a second, I think. So we'll go ahead and do that for the going up. And then for our send, again, we're going to figure out what we need this to go to. The first one is going to be this fan. Again, we're going to go ahead and can interact. Let's go ahead and grab this while we're here, since we know we're probably going to have issue with everything else. We're on the trap door right now. Let's go ahead and do that. We'll go ahead and paste that in. Can interact to false. That should be the fan right there. Go ahead and grab the fan, control V, can interact to false. And maybe if we're really lucky, we'll be able to grab this. Nope, that's the fan. Let's see, maybe. Nope, it's still the fan. All right, we might have to open this. Oh, I didn't do that. All right, here, actually, you know, it might work. Look at this. There we go. That works. Control V. Can interact. False. And now we're stuck. All right. Let's go ahead and get that to... Oh, no. We are stuck. Let's get rid of that. There we go. I can't believe I got us stuck in there. That's awesome. All right, let's go ahead and put that back because we want that back there. That was awesome. I got it stuck in our elevator. That's like the first time you get stuck in a Creativerse elevator. All right, so this should work now. So let's go ahead and see if it does. Hey, look at that. There you go. Oh, fell down. Why did I fall down? Okay, something happened there. What did I miss here? Did I... why did I... That was weird. I think I hit... I must have hit something here. Let's see here. Is the fan working? Oh, okay. I know what it is. It's because of the way that I have this set up. Because the trap door for these, like if you look here, are here, right? So you're gonna love this. This is an easy answer. It's because of the hitbox of a closed trap door. See, watch this. Now it won't do that. It's gonna do it perfectly. See? Yep, that's it. That's the whole reason. So we'll go ahead and put that there, at least until they figure out hitboxes. Oh, let's turn that the right way though. There. There we go. All right, and we'll just turn the can interact on that one off. That's too easy. We can fix that. See, I'm glad that all these little things are happening so that you guys can see why and what we're doing. All right, so that just makes that. And then you know what? If I had another... Here, you know, let's build... what am I doing? Let's build another one, and we'll just put that in here. Where did it go? Oh, there it is. And then it'll look the same for consistency's sake. There we go. Oh, why do I keep putting that on backwards? There we go. Awesome. Okay, and then it looks the same for just consistency. If I really wanted to, I could put another block up there. Okay, so that's all the way up. So let's try it from all the way down. Choo-choo. Nice. Nice functionality. Choo-chunk. Okay, we're out of it. Let's go ahead and go up. Choo-chunk. And up. And there it is. Okay. So we don't really need some of this here. The lights, maybe just because it'll look good. We don't really need the pressure plate there. I'm going to leave it there just because it's kind of cool. But we do need to bust in here so that we can put our inverter down. Okay, so depending on where you want to put the inverter, I'm just going to slap it right here. I think that'll be good. I didn't have to get rid of all that other stuff, too. Oh, where does the wall go? There it is. There we go. Okay, so we've got our inverter here. Now, our inverter is going to be hooked into our lights, just like the inverter was over here. So we have our green light, but we want our green light to be on the up. That way, everybody who comes over here will know that... Green down, green up. Okay, that's why I want to leave the lights here. So let's go ahead and change this to a green light and can interact to false. So let's go ahead and make that green. Save that. And now our inverter, we know already, is going to go to our green light. And the green lights are all going to get the same inverter signal. So let's go ahead and grab that now since we don't have to test it. We already know our circuit's going to work because we've already done it over there, right? So we'll grab that one, hit save. Well, we don't have to hit save. All right. And we got to do that to all the green lights. So let's go ahead and go get those. Okay. I love that. That's awesome. The 1 second delay might be a little bit long, but we'll play with it. We'll change it if we need to. Obviously, I'll take care of it. So change that to green. Output, can interact, save. Okay. So that'll go ahead and make that green when it's time. It will go down here. Right now, it shouldn't be anything because the inverter is not getting any kind of a signal. Okay, we'll go ahead down here. And there we go. Can interact. Make that green. And control V. There we go. And then that should be linked to the inverter as well. Okay, now we need to get all of these AND gates to go to all the red lights that are on the bottom. Now, they're not red yet. They will be very shortly. Okay, but we also need the clock to go to these as well. And then the clock is also going to go to the inverter. I'd like to go ahead and get the clock on the inverter first, just so that we can get our green lights hooked up. Okay, so let's go ahead and get in here. We'll go ahead and get our output here. Copy that, save, and let's go ahead and take our whole thing up. This is so cool, huh? Oh, I hit it again. I don't know. We'll play with it. Maybe it's the up on that one. I think that's what it is. All right, so this is going to get the receive from our clock down below. So we're going to go ahead and hit save on that. And now, if we... Oh, that's not connected to anything. It's there. It's like, oh, look, yeah, there's a thing there. But it's not. Okay. And there. And... why not? Oh, did I say clock? I didn't mean clock. That was stupid. I'm sorry. There are some of you going, what are you doing? And I'm going, I don't know. All right, we got to get it from the AND gates from all the different places. And I need to stop doing that. It's this one that goes down. All right, let's try that again. All right, we got to go get it from the AND gates. All right, here we go. Okay, let's go ahead and send the clock where it's supposed to go to these AND gates down here. There we go. All right, now let's go ahead and send this to the right places. All right, this is going to go to our red light. Well, all of our red lights. So all these red lights are going to get the same naming convention. So let's go ahead and grab that. Control C on that. Save that. And that should make this red. Go up. Oh, I didn't switch that to red. Let's go turn that to a red light. Okay, there we go. Let's try that again. Red color. There you go, red. Can't interact, false. Save that. Let's go up again. Red light. There you go. Look out, coming through, red light. All right, let's get that to be receiving that. Can't interact. Red light. Bam. That's coming from there. Let's make sure this is also sending the same signal. Okay, sending that. Boom, boom. Good, good. Let's go ahead and get these clock impulses to go to both sides of the input of that puppy right there. And that should be good. Let's have a red light, please. Thank you. Awesome. Now, this doesn't have that, but we would like to go ahead and have it have a red light input. Let's go there. Red. Control V. And that goes to the input of our inverter gate. There's a reason that I did this way, and I knew it was going to be simple and clean, and I messed that up. All right, so let's go ahead and get this all set up down here. Let's go all the way to the bottom, make sure everything works. Awesome, that worked just fine. Let's make sure this works. Red should turn green. Red should turn green. Excellent. Excellent. All right. Let's go ahead and put our blocks back in place. I think we've got blocks missing from down here. Excellent. Here. Block, block, block. Perfect. And then we'll double check to make sure we cleaned up our work down here. I don't think there's any issue. Yeah, I'll probably get rid of that 1 second delay. And there we go. Everything's working. So the green light says it's okay to go up. We can. Excellent. Okay, and then we'll cover that up when we actually finish the build down here. Okay, so that is up. All right, so great. Up was not that hard, was it? All right, let's go ahead and get some final thoughts put together in our heads. Okay, so that's our elevator put together. So we've got down on the left, up on the right, and everything seems to be working just fine. So I'm going to say that's a good build. That's solid. And we've got perfect functionality of our lights. We've got functionality of our up and down. And really, if you notice, the switching is just the same for up or down. It's not that hard to do for up or down. And actually, if you were going to do an up-down elevator shaft, which we are going to do at some point here, you would use exactly those same circuits. You would only use the side for down and the side for up. And then you'd have some method of saying whether or not you were going to use one or the other. Probably using some kind of a RS switch, you know, or latch rather, some kind of RS latch like we've already covered before, either a NOR or a NAND, depending on if you wanted your circuit to always be powered or unpowered. Okay, so just understand that this is not actually that difficult of a build, but it does have some, you know, little things that I threw in there with the LEDs. But the elevator itself, if you notice, was really easy. It was just a simple gate and a delay gate, or logic gate and a delay gate. And really, it was just all about making the spacing just right. Of course, you know, you see, it's not hard to build within the required parameters and still make something look good, you know, to still be able to follow the six floors. Now, here's the interesting thing. Let's say that you had double the size and you didn't have this middle floor here. Well, you could easily make this exactly the same way. You would just not have a floor that you could step off on. And you could have the trap door anywhere as long as you didn't exceed the six blocks, okay? Because once you start taking damage, people aren't gonna wanna ride your elevator anymore, all right? And just make sure that you have it set up the same way where it doesn't trigger except for that delay. Now, another final thought that some of you might have, or a question you might have, is why did we send everything to an AND gate first and then throw it into the clock? Well, something that I found a weird glitch in this game, and it has nothing to do with what you would normally do to a circuit. You could easily just have it go to the clock. But I found that it sometimes will not register the inputs correctly, or when it does, it'll register double hits. Sometimes, you know, trap doors will swing open and closed at will. It'll register as false, but it'll register as true. There's all kinds of weird things that'll happen, and I just figure putting it through this buffer, and what I've found is putting it through this AND gate, which is functioning as a buffer, tends to just even out the signal and make sure that the clock or the delay gate really is getting a pure true signal or a pure false signal when it's needed. So that's one final thought to add there. And then the other thing, of course, is you don't necessarily have to have the LEDs. That's just something I threw in. The minimum, of course, to go down would be your trap doors, your pressure plate, your AND gate, and your delay gate. Your minimum to go up, of course, is going to be your fans. Here, let me show you. There we go. Yeah, I'm going to change that 1 second delay. I don't like that. You're going to need your fans pretty much in this configuration. I've found that fans blow very well to get up that many spaces. And, you know, if you'll notice, that's exactly how many spaces separation we have. You know, is the 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and so on. I found that that's a very good configuration, and it's a good solid configuration. You need the trap door here to stop your upward movement, and then you need your pressure plate here. So, and then of course, you know, your AND gate and your delay gate. You don't need the LEDs. That's just a thing that I like and that I threw in there because that's what I wanted. Okay. So thank you for watching this. I hope you've learned something. If you have questions or comments or concerns, please, please, please leave them in the comments below. This I will help you with. I know this. Heck, I thought of it, so I know it intimately. This is not something that's difficult, for me at least. So I can help you as much as you want or as little as you want. Just the only thing you gotta do is ask. Visit my world. Come take a look at this. I'm going to take the doors down up there, the security doors. As a matter of fact, I'll do that right now so you know I'm not kidding you. All right, let's go ahead and take this all down right now. We don't need this anymore. All right, there's no security in here. No security. Look at this right there. And the hitboxes for doors still messed up. There you go. Open to all. Access to the public. Welcome. Come on down. Come take a look at my animals. All right, there you go. The zoo is open. All right, come ride the elevator. Now, be careful, though. The game still has that glitch right now with the pressure plate. So you come down here and it doesn't work. I'm sorry about your luck. I don't know what to tell you. You know, it's working. You've seen the functionality here in the video. But you're welcome to come take a look at this and go ahead and get your own ideas out of it. I will eventually put it up on the other side as well. So we're going to have elevators on both sides. Until then, thank you for watching. Appreciate your time. Appreciate you watching. And peace.